Hello students, so we are still in chapter 5 and I am covering this chapter very slowly because this is the foundation chapter basically where it is talking about the concepts basically. So one of the major concepts is the stability. Okay, so chapter 5 is many other things, but today I am going to talk about the stability and in particular Rao's stability. Rao's stability criteria. The stability we already know, right? And we say that depending on the characteristic equation. So let us say TS equal to PS over QS, where both are polynomial, right? Then characteristic equation is basically QS equal to 0. So we are talking about this. So just by examining the characteristic equation, you can find out whether system is going to be stable or not. When you say stable, that really means this comes back to the mean position. Okay, so the example for is maybe QS equal to, let us say, 1 over S plus A, example I gave. If that is the thing, if you have QS equal to S, not 1 over S plus A, but S plus A, just S plus A. S plus A, and then a characteristic equation becomes X plus A equal to 0, and hence you get what? S equal to minus A. And then what you do? You plot where in the S plane, complex S plane, and this is S. If S equal to sigma plus I omega, sigma is the real part, so you could get sigma here, and here into I omega, and this value minus A will be here. We can say here S plus equal to 0, where A equal to greater than 0. Hence, minus A will be greater than, less than 0, negative. And this will tell us this is stable. So, as long as roots of S are on the left, so roots of QS equal to 0, okay, if they lie on the left half S plane, then stable, meaning that if the points are here, all these points, here points, all those points will tell you stable. Not on the vertical imaginary axis. This is not included, not on this one, but all these points will be stable. All this other side will be unstable. So you can say unstable here, unstable, this is stable. This is also stable, and this line is, we also call it marginally stable, okay. A term you use, in some cases, this is okay, this condition is okay. So, but as I said, for all practical purposes, this is as good as unstable one. We will treat this as on this line also, if the points are this line, we will call it unstable. This is also unstable. So for a stable, you have to be on the left side or negative side of the S plane. This is called S plane. Okay. So here also that means is the real part of the roots of plus s real part of the roots of qs equal to 0. If less than 0, then stable. So now the roots of s can also be complex number. In that case, just look at the real part. If the real part has a negative number, then it will be stable. Okay, so all these are, just looking at it, this is the, I explain in terms of the S plane. You can derive also, you can see why I'm saying like that. So example, this example, if you see QS S plus A, so this could be, for example, the TS could be 1 over S plus A. And hence, let us say you are giving a impulse, so RS equal to 1 and that CS equal to TS multiplied by RS equal to, in this case RS equal to 1 will be S plus A only, and CT is given by inverse Laplace of this, and hence you get e to the power minus AT. Hence, when t goes to infinity, ct becomes equal to 0. Means the position where it started, at ct equal to 0, it will go back to ct equal to 0. So the plot is something like this one, right? So you started with here, then before the impulse, it was here, then after the impulse, it went here, and then slowly in the long run, this becomes 0, hence it is stable. It comes back to the original position. This one. But the original position comes back to this one. Now, if A is negative in this case, if A is equal to, less than equal to 0, then what happens? Ct equal to infinity when t tends to infinity. So the value becomes something like this, goes on like this, when A is less than 0. Okay, then in S plus A equal to 0 equation, if A is less than 0, if A is negative number, then what happens? Then your response to one impulse becomes infinity at t equal to infinity, because this will go something like this. Keep on increasing, hence it's not stable. Original position was this one, then you have the impulse hitting here, and after that, what you see is exponentially increasing output. So this is not stable. Hence what you see here, when A is negative, it's not stable. A is negative means it will come this side. S equal to minus A is the root. When A is positive, value is here. A is negative, value is here. And this will be unstable. So this is the reason why I'm saying that. Other example, okay, so in this example only, notice one thing, because we are talking about the Rao's stability criteria. This is not the Rao's stability criteria. This is just the thing that I mentioned last time. And we are going to connect it more now. Okay, so what we see so far is the example, if you take S plus A equal to 0, this is QS, characteristic equation. What you see here is this A is positive, then stable. This S is negative, then unstable. Rao's stability criteria, if you know, just looking at it, you will see that A is positive, you will tell it's stable. If S is negative, you will call it unstable. I will tell the details, but we are just starting from here. We will go to more complex now. This is like a first order system, believe something like that. Now, let us say you have QS equal to S square a s plus b equal to 0. Yeah, okay. Here, s, the Cartesian equation, is that this one, right? Meaning that the ts will be something like, let us say, 1 over qs. Maybe the transfer function, and where qs is given by this one. Now, looking at it, if you know the Rouse stability criteria, you can, looking at it, you will tell whether this system will be stable or not. Okay, in order to connect it, let's first, our way, whatever we studied, based on that, whether we can predict it or not. And what, how we will do? We will do like this. S equal to minus a plus minus root a square minus 4b. This is what the root will be, because this quadratic equation divided by 2. Now the criteria, it says that we have to be all the roots on this side. And we know exactly why it should be. Why on here? Okay, probably that, let us say you have a quadratic equation, this one, not this one. Let us say you have this. Ts equal to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. If you have that, then what do you get? You get the solutions. You get, in this case, s you will get as, you can have like this one. You mean like this one. And then here you will get s square plus 2 zeta omega n plus s plus zeta omega n square, right? Plus, here becomes minus zeta square omega n square plus omega n square and omega n square over s square plus 2 zeta, we write it like here, s plus zeta omega n square plus omega n square, write like this, omega n and root 1 minus zeta square square. Yeah, this is what we studied. And hence, if we make this quadratic equation, this will, the root, this is ps equal to omega n square, this is qs. Qs equal to 0 will give us s equal to, this becomes the minus zeta omega n plus minus I omega n root 1 minus zeta square. This is the roots, the two roots. Two roots, because there are two of them, plus minus both. What you see here, we have I here, right? And then this is the real. This one tells you that the second order system, and this is the underdamped system. And if you want to plot it here, how will you plot? We can plot it like this. Like this, and then minus zeta omega n. So you have minus zeta omega n here, and plus minus omega n, and here you have, and here 2 points up. The value of this is equal to omega n, right, like this, I omega n root under 1 minus zeta square. Actually, the points are this and this, the same value from here to here. So this is also I omega n root 1 minus zeta square. These are the roots. here and here for this condition, for this underdamped condition. And this tells you this is stable. This is basically stable. Stable. Why? Because it is on the left hand side of the S-plane. It is not lying on the y-axis. This is complex. Roots are complex. It is not on the x-axis either. But this is on the left side, on the negative side. This is the real part of the root which is negative, minus zeta multiplied omega n. Hence, this is a stable. You know that the response for this one is for a impulse loading. Let us say till here it is at zero. You give impulse loading, it will go like this, and then it will stabilize at this position. Hence, this is a stable. This is for impulse. This is CT I'm talking about. Then for a step input also, this is stable, because for a step input this will go like this and finally it will be zero. See, not zero but maintain at one or whatever value depending on the step. The unit step, let us say, this is stabilizing at one. RT is also one, the system, this system we are talking about. So basically this will tell you, depending the root basically tells us they are stable or not, and this system is going to tell the stable. Okay, by the way, if this is zeta omega n, this is omega n root, like this one, from here to here this will be simply omega, the zeta omega n, this is omega n, this will be simply omega n. If you square this one, zeta square omega n square, plus this one is omega n square 1 minus zeta square, you add both of them, you get omega n. So from here to here the value is omega n. And hence this is and accordingly you can find out theta as well. This phi will be equal to the tan phi is will be equal to, so here you have omega n root 1 minus zeta square over zeta omega n. So you have this, so like this you get this one. So this phi you can get from here also. So anyway, what we get from here is the root is going to tell where on the S-plane the roots are going to lie, or hence it's stable or not. This system tells us it is stable. This is showing the result, just to what we know. So you know that this part, the solution, if you look at the solution, one, there's some decay. At the same time, there is some wave also. Why? Because of this root, we can write this. So till here, I will follow up later on this one. This, if let us say your equation is TS is given by the omega n square over S square plus 2 zeta omega n plus omega n square. And hence, you can write this as a function of some A divided by this one minus zeta omega n, s plus zeta omega n, right, plus I omega d, let's call it, this whole thing is omega d, plus b over s plus zeta omega n minus I omega d. You can also write like this one. And hence, what is the solution? Solution is, as you know, if you take the inverse Laplace transform, so for RS equal to 1, that is impulse loading. For impulse loading, RS equal to 1 and CS equal to TS simply, right? And CT in that case will be CT equal to L inverse Cs, and which is equal to, if the take of this one, what do you get? You will get a e to the power, so I write it here, equal to a e to the power, what? This one, what? Minus zeta omega n minus I omega d plus b e to the power minus zeta omega n, right? There will be t here also, right? I omega t here, yeah? So plus b zeta omega n t, right? And plus I omega d t. Okay, this is what we get. That really means it will have some e to the power minus zeta omega n t in common, and then you will have a, and then you have the minus omega d t here. So this minus part, so you get e to the power some sinusoidal term, so you get a cos omega dt minus a sine omega dt plus b cos omega dt, right, and so on, plus b sine omega dt. There will be i term here, similarly there will be i term here. What you see here you have e to the power minus zeta omega n t. So since this is after the negative sign, these values are all positive, hence this will die out as t tends to infinity, and this is sinusoidal term, and hence you will, the response to an impulse is like this. You have decaying with time, you know, so this whatever you are seeing like this one is coming from e to the power minus zeta omega nt term. This is e to the power minus zeta omega nt term, and here sinusoidal, and within that envelope what you have is sinusoidal term which is oscillating like this. In long term ct becomes zero, hence the original position was zero, the reference is zero, and the output also becomes zero, hence it is stable. This is maintained, it goes to a position, it stabilizes, it remains in that position. So this one is, hence this is stable. So this is what the meaning of this. Okay, now so far I was trying to explain why it's important to have the real part of the root to be negative, and this one is the reason. If the real part negative, then you have e to the power minus zeta omega t, you will have e to the power minus let us say if you have here, instead of like this one, if your transfer function is something like 1 over s square plus a square, let us say, you have like this one. Hence, s equal to plus minus ia. And in that case, these points will lie from here and here on the line itself, and these will be marginally stable, or for all practical purposes, they are unstable. We treat them like unstable. Yeah. So we have seen all kind of situations. We have seen the situation where it purely lies on this line. We have seen purely lying on these lines, or here, or here. In all cases, whenever the root is on the left side of this plane, yeah, not on that line also, on the left side, strictly on the left side, then that system will be stable. Mind it, all roots have to follow the same thing. All roots have to be on the left side. Okay. Now, these are the stability coming from the equation, just looking at the equation, you will find that it's important for the root to be on the left side of the s-plane. Rather, the stability criteria tells you how to spot, just looking at the characteristic equation, how to find out whether this will be stable or not. It is, although it's based on this only, the idea here is also to make the all the roots to be negative, or the real parts of all the roots to be negative. That is what the aim is. Basically, Rath stability criteria tells you the conditions of the conditions of the coefficient in the characteristic equation. Characteristic equation QS equal to 0. Conditions of the coefficient in the characteristic equation QS equal to 0 to make the system stable. Purely it is looking at the coefficient. Let's say it's S square plus Sn, let us say Sn plus A1 Sn minus 1 plus A2 Sn minus 2, like this one. Let's go till Sn minus 1 plus An minus 1 S plus An and like this equal to 0. Let us say this is the characteristic equation. This is QS equal to like this one. So Rao's stability criterion will just look at these coefficients only, and it will just based on that it can predict whether the system is stable or not, meaning that it can predict whether roots have all the roots have it will predict whether all the roots have negative real part. That's what it does. Okay, this is what the Rao stability criterion is. Okay, so I'm just building up to it. So hence I have to tell the background so that you understand where we are heading to. Let us look here. Think in this term, QS equal to S plus A characteristic equation for the first order system, S equal to 0. Here, the root becomes S equal to minus A. So if it is stable, when this system will be stable when A is equal to 0. Right? Positive then stable, right? And this is unstable when A is less than equal to 0. As simple as that. So what it tells you is coefficient, this A has to be positive. A has to be positive. This is the straightforward method, the straightforward outcome of this analysis. What about this one? Let us say, now you have this equation, quadratic equation, this characteristic equation. Let us say you have Ts equal to 1 over Qs, and you are examining this one. You can have also Ps here, P could be 1 plus S over this, could be, doesn't matter, still, this is the one which will appear in denominator, hence denominator plays a bigger role, right? So hence we are analyzing only the denominator only, yeah? Here, what we know is, if S, what we know here? The real part and imaginary part. So you have S equal to 2, S1 is equal to minus A over 2 plus root A square minus 4b, and second S2 will be minus A over 2 minus root A square minus 4b. Okay, here also we have divided by 2, so minus 1 over 2. this is 1 over 2. Look here. We have two possibilities. One, either case 1, a square minus 4ab is greater than 0. Means all real roots, right? If a square minus 4b is equal to these all real roots, or simply in that case, the requirement will be, in any case, to make it stable, our condition is has to be equal to 0 for stability. For stability, this is the condition. Both the roots has to be negative. This is the condition. But among that, we have two conditions, a square minus 4b, either it will be plus, positive or negative. So we are looking at case one, this is a positive number, so that all real roots, both, not instead of all, let's write both real roots. Both real roots. In this case, what do we get? Then we'll get S1 will be minus A over 2 plus, and here there is something positive, half into something positive number. And S2 will be minus A over 2 plus something negative number. So this is also negative. How do you know? If in this case, what we get to know is, if this is also negative and this is also, if A is positive, if A is, will be negative, if A is positive. If A is positive, then this becomes negative, this also part is negative, this also part is negative, and hence it will be more negative than minus A over 2, and hence it will be fine. So what we get, condition we get, A greater than 0 will make make the system stable. In this case, what happens? Now with this one, minus A over 2 plus half, like this one. Again, in this case also, if A is greater than 0, is a must, so that this can compensate the other part. And how much? This value has to be more than this value. Yeah? And hence, then what do you get? Basically, in that case, what you need to get from here, look at this one. It tells you that root A square minus 4b has to be less than A. That's why I tell you. And where A is positive, right? This is A is positive. Yeah? The whole thing, this is also positive. Let's assume this one root, we are already taken plus minus. So we are assuming this to be positive, and we are saying that A square minus 4ab is positive, right? So that really means a square both the sides, you get A square minus 4b less than A square minus 4b is negative number, and that tells you when b is equal to a positive number. So to make this S1 negative, you need a condition. What condition? A has to be equal greater than 0, b also has to be equal to 0. In this case, what do you get? As long as A is greater than 0, it will be fine. But we have to take both into account. Hence, this condition will be applied. Meaning that in the first case, when A square minus 4ab greater than 0, the system is stable when A is greater than 0 and B is greater than 0. Okay? We are getting some conditions automatically. Of course, we are just analyzing. I am doing this in front of you so that you can relate to the Rao's stability criteria. You know, so that's why I am doing. Otherwise, a statement is very simple. A statement is not a big thing. Okay, now second case 2, what is the case 2 will be, this will be maybe less than 0. So will be a square minus 4 b less than zero, and in this case you get here imaginary number. Hence we don't have to worry about, as long a is greater than 0, we are fine, system is stable. This condition, when a is common as 4 a b greater than 0 and s1 when you have plus here, this one is the more crucial than meaning that it tells you that if a is greater than 0, b is greater than 0, as long as a is greater than 0, b is greater than 0, this is going to be a stable. Okay, what it tells you that if qs is equal to s square plus as plus b, okay, system is stable. Qs equal to 0, right? System is stable if a is greater than 0 and b is greater than 0. If a and b both are positive, you will guarantee the stability of the system. Very interesting observation you can make. Here also it tells you a has to be positive. Here also you say a has to be positive, b has to be positive. Simply what it is telling you is coefficients have to be positive. In the characteristic equation, all the coefficients have to be positive, and this is the necessary condition for stability. Okay, I'm going to repeat it again. So what we said, Ts equal to Rs Cs over Rs is equal to Ps over Qs, and where Qs equal to 0 is characteristic equation, and Qs may be of the form of As, you just write it like this, Sn plus A1 Sn minus 1, so on, then a n minus 1 s plus a n equal to 0 is the characteristic equation. Right? Qs is equal to 0. Now, Rao's stability criteria says first thing, Rao's stability criteria, that tells you number one is coefficient, all coefficient are positive, meaning that ai greater than 0, 4i equal to 1 to n, and this is all coefficients are positive for stability. Okay, all coefficient must be positive. Must be. Let me write positive myself. Must be positive for stability. Okay, this is necessary condition, not sufficient. Necessary condition, this you must have. Even if this condition satisfy, it is not necessarily it is stable. It tells you this necessary condition means this is required, then further condition is also needed, but this is the minimum condition that you need. So all coefficients must be positive, and this also you can find out in terms of that. Let us say Qs has n roots, so s you can write as s plus bi, right? This is product of that. So you say b1 is plus b2 and so on. S plus bn. Let us say all real roots equal to 0, like this one. You can see that if all bi are positive, right? The system will be stable only when b1, b2 will be positive, so that s equal to minus b. Roots are s equal to minus b1, minus b2 to minus bn. Now, all will be negative only when s, the roots are negative. Roots are negative only when b1, b2 to bn, bn all are greater than 0. All positive, right? So individually b1, b2 to bn, all of them positive, then only the roots will be negative and hence the system will be stable, right? So that really means this is what the characteristic equation is, where b1, b2 to bn all are positive. This system is stable only when all b1, b2, bn all are positive. But when all are positive, the coefficients are also positive. If all the bi are positive, coefficients have to be positive. And hence it is a necessary condition. So this you can say equal to Sn plus b1, b2 to bn, right? S n minus 1 plus you have b1, b2 plus b2, b3 plus like this, right? And then S n minus 2 and so on. If b1, b2 to bn all positive, so you have positive, this also positive and so on. Hence what it tells you simply that if the system is stable, in the characteristic equation, all the coefficient will be positive, has to be positive. Yeah? Where our characteristic equation is given like this. Remember, we have coefficient equal to 1 here. Yeah, so we have to bring that in this form to check it. Okay. One thing we also notice that, let us say Sn you have, and here this value is 0, meaning that if some characteristic equation does not have a coefficient, missing coefficient, let us say a1 is 0, means you have Sn plus, directly you have s to power n minus 2. S to power n minus 1, the coefficient of that, means a1 is 0, but that is only possible when some of them has to be negative, so that all summation will be 0. That means there are some negative roots, right? That really positive roots, that really means there are some positive roots in that case. Hence the system will not be stable. So strictly it is required that strictly all coefficients have to be there in this nth order system. All coefficients have to be there to be stable. So if there is a system, something like let us say we have s cube plus s plus 1, will tell you this is not stable. Why? S squared term is not there, means coefficient here will be 0, hence it is not stable. Just looking at that, you can find out now. That is the power of this. All coefficients have to be there, all coefficients have to be positive, okay? Provided the characteristic equation is in this form, you have to write in this form first, okay? Positive I am saying because this coefficient is 1, which is positive, it is also positive. If you put a negative here, so all of them have to be negative then, means same sign. You can also say that it is system is stable when all the coefficients have the same sign. When all the coefficients are either negative or positive. You can also say that. Yeah? Okay. And all coefficients have to be there, and all coefficients are either negative or positive. Means either you have minus here, minus, 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 like this one, or you have plus, 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 everything. That's what it means. But if you put here coefficient as 1, which is positive, automatically it means that all coefficients have to be positive. And hence, I'm writing like this. Remember that. Now, let us talk about the sufficient condition. Sufficient condition was proposed by Routh, and it can be proved, but proving requires very high, the complex, the advanced level of mathematics, and hence this is not part of your syllabus. Here what we can just see that we can relate with the examples only. Yeah, and the sufficient condition is basically you have to accept the way it is, because proving that requires advanced level of mathematics. That kind of mathematics you did not have during your first year and second year courses. Hence, we will just take as it is without any proof. Okay, and what that is, you make a Routh table. You call Routh table, and what you do? So this is QS equal to A1. So not A1 here. It will be SN plus A0. A1, Sn minus 1, and so on till you have An minus 1, S plus you have An. Yeah, this is the line, this one. Okay, what it tells that you just make a table, you just write like this, you write Sn here, because this is number of rows will be fixed according to this one. The number of rows will be, in your case, from Sn to S0, basically. So that tells you how many the terms you have here. So it goes Sn to S0 term. So hence you have n plus 1 term. So you make a table in which you have Sn, then you have S minus 1, and Sn minus 2, Sn minus 3, like that. And at the end you have Sn minus 1, Sn, you have S1 term, S, and then you have S0 term. So many rows will be there. Then what you do? Here you are going to write the coefficient. But remember, coefficient here is 1. You write 1 here. Now, then this will be either all odds, either all odd or even, right? So here let us say call it odd or even. Here if this is odd, this will be even or odd. So if this is odd, this will be even. If this is even, this will be odd, right? So meaning that you have 1, and then after that A1 will go here, A2 will go here, A3 will go here, A4, A5, A6, A7, and so on. You are going to write like this, right? Okay, so see here, A0, in a way it's A0 equal to, you can say A0 equal to 1, right? So here A0, A1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on, you are going to write like that. This is how you will find out. Then we will do some operation. What kind of operation? This will be this multiplied by this minus this by this divided by this. So here how we are going to write? A1 times A2 minus 1 times A3 divided by A1. This multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, this multiplied by this minus this multiplied by this divided by this. We write like this one. Yeah. Similarly here, you will write here A3 A4 minus A2 A5 divided by A3. Similarly here you write A5 A6 minus, okay, so this will be the term here, second term, like this one. Yeah, so basically just we write like this one, or we can include A0, let's call A0 here, A naught term, we write A naught here like this. Okay, so general purpose A naught, we write like this one, A naught here like this, A naught like this one. Let's call this one as A naught like this one. Let's call it B1. Yeah, B1, B2, B3, and so on. Let's call it B4. C1. C2, C3, and so on. There's a relationship though. How you find out B1, B2, right? Here, you and so on. You have to work out like this until everything becomes zero. Basically, we have to work out till here. Till S naught, you have to work out. Okay? So because finally, there is some zero here. You will get triangular matrix sort of, where you will get some values here, this value all becomes zero. So you get all some values here in the first half of this square matrix, basically. It is not a matrix, but it's a table. So here value of B1, A1, A0, A1, A2, all you get from the coefficients. Now B1 will be equal to A1 times A2 minus A naught divided by A3 divided by A1. Or in general you can write BI, similarly this one, right? So B2 will be equal to A3 A4 minus A2 A5 divided by A3. In general you can write BI equal to AI plus 1, okay, B2 in general, okay, leave it right now, but in simply you can do like this, right? This multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, and this multiplied by this minus this multiplied by this divided by this one. So, and so on. You can write like, and so on. And so on. And similarly, you can find out now C will be equal to C1 is equal to B1 times A3 minus A1 times B2 divided by B1. Yeah, then C2 is equal to B2 A5 minus A3 B3 divided by B2, and so on. So this is how you keep on doing, and similarly if you have SN minus 4, D1, D2, D3, and so on, you can here also do the same way. Yeah? Right? So D1 will be equal to C1 times B2, like this one. Or simply we can write DI is equal to, here we can give a formula, CI multiplied by bi plus 1 minus bi times ci plus 1 divided by ci, and so on, right? Okay, so you will make a table. Whatever you get here, the first column will tell you information. What information? For stability, this is the sufficient condition. For stability, all values in the first column greater than zero or same size, all values in the column have the same size, have the same sign. So either positive or negative. If a not to be taken as 1, then all has to be positive, right? So that really means if a not equal to n, then all positive. For what? For stability. This will tell you, this column will tell you whether the system is stable or not. And how it will tell you? You look at this, if all of them have same sign, this positive, all of them positive, that means the system is stable. If you have one positive, one negative, then that really means it is not stable. Okay, now it can also tell you how many roots are negative or how many roots are on the positive side of the S-plane. Number of unstable roots, I'm saying unstable root. Meaning that roots, the real part of that is positive. That I'm referring to unstable roots. Number of unstable roots equal to number of change in sign in first column. You look at here, you see how many times this is changing the sign. Let us say plus, then minus, then plus. So plus to minus, one change, minus to plus, second change, after that no change, hence there will be two roots on the right side, on the real side, on the right side. So this is S. If there are two change of sign, hence it will have two roots here, either here or here. There will be two roots on right side. That's what it tells you. So the Rolle's stability criteria tells you basically first thing is for stability, all the coefficients have to be of the same sign, either all positive, all negative. Why? Because if all negative, and because all everything equal to zero, hence you can get rid of negative signs, hence becomes all positive anyway. Yeah, so doesn't matter whether all positive or all negative have the same meaning, and hence general purpose you can write like that. So what tells you that the necessary condition, all coefficients have to be on same sign, means either all positive and all negative. Second thing is that is the necessary condition. The sufficient condition is you make a Rolle's table and then you look at the first column. If all of them have the same sign, then it is stable. If there is any change, if there's a zero, then means also it is not stable. That really means this may happen because of the marginal stability, right? The purely complex root. In that case, there may be zero coming here. So second sufficient condition is all the coefficients in the first column have to be strictly positive. Yeah, okay. And also it tells you how many roots are resulting into instability. Okay, so then you see the sign, how the coefficients are changing the sign, the, how the first these the first column values in the first column is changing the sign. So you have to count if it's a plus to minus, then minus to plus, how many changes are there, and that will tell you the tell you the number of roots that have positive real part, and hence which is making the system unstable. So this is what the Raoult's stability criteria. So let's look at some simple examples. Okay, so first we will start with a known solution. So let us say the characteristic equation is QS equal to let us say S plus 1, S plus 2, and hence what do you get? You get S square plus 3S plus 2. We will check this one. What we know is this is stable. S plus 1 plus S plus 2, so you know that roots are S equal to minus 1 and minus 2, and that really means that the system is stable. That we know. Now, Raoult's stability criteria we are going to check. First, we look at the coefficient. We have 1 here, 3 here, 2 here, all positive. All positive. Hence, necessary condition satisfied. Check. Right? Okay. Now, second thing is we make a Raoult's table. And how you make it? We write S square, then we write S, then S naught. How you are doing? We are writing here 1, then we are writing 3 here, here writing 2, here it is 0, right? And then how we do? 3 times 2, 6, minus 0 divided by 3. So S1 will be 3 times 2 minus 3 times 2 minus 1 times 0 equal to 0 divided by 3, which is equal to 2 only, right? Equal to 2. So value is 2 here, there is no value here, so it will be 0 here, right? So look at this one, we have 1, we have 3, we have 2, all positive value, same sign, hence stable. Yeah, okay. Now take another example, and which example? We take QS equal to S plus 1, S minus 2. What we know is there is one root which is going to be positive, and hence it is going to be unstable. Okay, so equal to S square minus S plus minus 2, right? Okay, and hence you are looking at one positive here, positive, here negative, here negative. We know that this is unstable. Yeah? Hence, no need to check further. We know it's unstable. That's it. Yeah? Okay. Now look at QS equal to S plus 2 and S minus 1. Yeah? You have like this one, and hence you will get S square plus S minus 2, right? Here also you have 1 and minus 2 here, right? This is 1 misses, this is a positive, this is positive, and here you have negative. Again it tells you unstable, like that. So just looking at here, you find that this is not good, this is, it is not stable. You can also make a table. So for, let us say for this one you want to make table. So S square, you have 1 and then minus 2, and then for S 1 you have 1, right? And then you have S 0. okay, 0 here. So here what you get, 1 times minus, so 1 times minus 2, minus 2, minus 0 divided by 1, that this becomes equal to minus 2, 0 here, right? So what you get, 1, 1, minus 2, minus 2 here, meaning that all are not the same sign, hence unstable. How many roots have positive real part? Here to here, same sign, here to here, one sign change. Okay, hence number of roots with positive real part equal to 1, because number of sign change. 1, 1, no sign change. 1 to minus 2, 1 sign change. Yeah. Similarly, you can check, let us say, QS equal to S minus 2, S minus 1. So you have S square, then you have minus 2S, minus 3S, plus you have 2, right? So we can say, looking at this one, you will reject it, because you will say this is minus coefficient here, negative coefficient, hence it's not stable. Looking at that, you can find out, right? Okay, now right here, S square, then you have S1, and then you have S naught. S square, you have 1, and then minus 3 here, and here you have 2. 0 here. How you find out? You find out minus 3 multiplies by 2, minus 0 divided by minus 3 here, and which is equal to 2 simply. Here you have 0. Now look at this first column, 1 minus 3, 2. What do you see? There is a sign change, unstable. Because different sign. Okay. Second thing is, 1 to minus 3 sign change, minus 3 is to 2, second sign change. So number of roots with positive real part equal to 2. Why? There are two sign change, 1 to minus 3, the minus 3 is to 2, 1, minus 3 to 2. So two sign change, hence there are two roots which have positive real path. So this is what the Rao's stability criterion, mostly deals with this table basically. This table automatically have the all other information. However, just looking at the coefficient also, you can find out, you can go from there. Yeah, okay. So this is what it is, okay. Now more you do the practice, more you will have insight about this one. But this is a very powerful tool. Just looking at the equation, quadratic equation, you can tell whether the system is stable or not. That is all for today.